Hey everyone, in this video we're going to talk about how we can install Tkinter into Python on a Mac. In this video we're going to be installing Tkinter directly from the Mac terminal, allowing you to use Tkinter in your Python shells, which we'll talk about more here shortly. Before we begin, if you do not have Python installed, just click on the link in the top right hand corner of your screen now, or check out the link in the description down below and you can quickly learn how to download and get started in Python. To ensure that we have Python installed correctly, and to get started, let's hit Command and Spacebar to open up our Mac's search feature. Then let's type terminal. Within our terminal, let's type Python and then hit Tab. This should show you all of your Python editions. As I want to be working in the latest version of Python, let's just type 3.9 and hit Enter. This will show you a bit of information confirming that Python is installed correctly. Now, we don't actually want to do anything with this right now, so let's quit this out like so. Now, to work in a Mac's terminal with Python code, we need to first create a virtual environment that will contain all of our project's information. I also want to store this file onto our Mac's desktop so that it is easily findable. So let's type ls and hit enter, and you should see desktop as one of the directories that we can move to. So let's type cd, change directory, and then desktop. Now, to create a Python virtual environment, let's tell the terminal that we want a Python 3.9 -m venv study session. So this is saying let's make a Python 3.9 virtual environment called study session. But you can obviously call this file whatever you wish. Now you can see when we list our desktop's available directories here, that is what ls does, we now have a file or a directory called study session, which is a Python virtual environment that we just created. But how do we go about entering that virtual environment? Well, as you can see here, when I list the contents of StudySession's bin, we have a file called activate. And we are going to type source space our newly created environment's name, so StudySession slash bin slash activate. Now, on the left of our input line, we can see that we are now working within the StudySession environment. This line is telling Python to only run scripts out of the StudySession shell only. Now that our virtual environment is created, there's not much more for us to do, as Tkinter is part of the standard Python library, meaning that we do not need to download any additional libraries. So, to test if Tkinter is installed correctly, let's create a simple blank GUI. To do so, let's begin by creating our main running GUI window, which we can create with a variable called whatever you want, but I will call it main equals tk, for shorthand for the Tkinter library, dot tk brackets. Let's save this file to our newly created Python virtual environment as a Python file, so dot py. Navigating back to our terminal window and ensuring that we are in the correct directory, we can run the Python file we just created through Python and then our file name. So we'll type Python space simple GUI dot py. This blank GUI appearing is proof that Tkinter is now working in our newly created Python virtual environment. I hope that this helped you getting started with Tkinter on a Mac. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.